Recently, we had a patient come into the clinic with an eyelid twitch, and she ended up having a tumor. Now, this is scary and also very rare, but that does bring up the question, when does an eyelid twitch become serious? When should we worry? Let's focus in. So we're going to break this down into four different conditions that include an eye twitch, starting with number one, and this one is by far the most common that we see in the clinic. Maybe 99% of the patients that we see with an eyelid twitch have this condition, and it's called myokymia or eyelid myokymia. This is the condition that you likely have experienced sometime in your life. You might be experiencing it right now. I've experienced it multiple times in my life. Now, luckily, this is benign. It's not dangerous. It will resolve on its own. It doesn't make it any less annoying, though. But the easiest way to categorize this is to know where the twitch is happening. With myokymia, it either happens on one eye, either the left or the right eye, and it usually happens on one eyelid, either the top or the bottom, most commonly the bottom eyelid, and it usually happens on one small muscle, meaning it's not multiple muscles kind of flexing there. And so if you remember that, one eye, one eyelid, one small muscle. And this is where you'll get this little flutter or twitch. It might even feel like it's kind of moving your vision a little bit. And yeah, definitely the most common one that we see. Here's the huge list of possible causes for an eyelid myokymia, with the top three definitely being lack of sleep, increased stress, and increased caffeine intake. And usually it resolves by itself, can last a few days, up to a week, sometimes 2 weeks. If it lasts longer than 2 weeks, then yeah, you definitely wanna go into your doctor and start having everything checked to make sure it might not be something else that we'll talk about in this video. And usually the treatment for this, like I said, self-resolving, but you kinda go down the list and you try and reduce what might be causing it, whether it's sleep, reducing caffeine, reducing stress if you can, treating your dry eyes, taking magnesium supplements, whatever the cause might be. So if a patient comes into the clinic with an eye twitch, likely it's gonna be myokymia, but it's our job to figure out if it's one of the other conditions that we'll talk about. And one of the questions that we usually ask people is if the eye twitch is happening in both eyes and both eyelids to the point where it's actually kind of closing their eyes. Maybe it's making it tricky for them to open their eyes up during the clench or during the spasm. If the answer is yes, then it could be something called a benign essential blepharospasm. Now, this is definitely not as common as myokymia, but still affects up to 50,000 Americans right now. The overall cause can still be a mystery. They know that it does come from an abnormality or disruption in the part of the brain that controls eyelid movement or eyelid function, but how that happens is kind of a mystery sometimes. It can be linked to stress or anxiety. It can also be linked to certain medications. If you have Parkinson's and you're taking some medications, those medications can trigger blepharospasms. Sometimes bright light has been known to trigger blepharospasms, and this can actually run in families. There can be a genetic component to this. Now, I was reading a little bit more in the research. There are a few cases that come up because the brain does get involved that they did find tumors that were causing blepharospasms. And so if you do have a bilateral condition where the eyelids are squeezing the eyelids shut, and it's kind of chronic, been going on for a while, you definitely wanna go in and get the eyes checked. Maybe you need to get neurological testing, sometimes MRI. There's a small chance, but there's a chance that it could be something going on in the brain, such as a growth, like a tumor. But usually with this, it can be treated with Botox. And this is probably the most common type of treatment to get Botox, just to relax those muscles. Okay, moving back to one side of the face. If it's only happening on one eye, the next question that we usually ask patients is if that twitch is starting to migrate or if it's twitching any other muscle groups. Meaning, is it twitching both eyelids? Is it maybe twitching a little bit into the cheek, lower cheek, or by the mouth? And if so, if it's all on one side, then it could be two other possible conditions. This being either facial myokymia, similar to myokymia, but happening on one side of the face, or it could be hemifacial spasm. And these two conditions are oftentimes used interchangeably, they're oftentimes confused with each other, and their presentations and symptoms are really similar. And this, like I said, not just twitches on the eyelid, but you're starting to get twitches on the cheek or mouth, just on one side of the face. Now, the type of twitch or how they describe the twitch might be a little bit different. With facial myokymia, sometimes they'll say the twitch is kind of a wave like twitch, or sometimes they'll say it feels like worms are kind of twitching into the face. And with hemifacial spasms, they're kind of sudden repetitive twitches. And so they can be a little bit different in that aspect. With facial myokymia, a lot of the causes are similar to myokymia, like we listed before. It can be self-resolving. A lot of times this might last a little bit longer, from weeks to months, however. But the difference here is now we might be getting the facial nerve involved. And this is where it can change a little bit here. So in the case of hemifacial spasm, because we have the facial nerve involved, we need to figure out what is making the facial nerve behave that way. And kind of the top three that we're looking for, one could be MS, multiple sclerosis. Another one could be anything pressing on that nerve. And this could be an aneurysm or a tumor. And so a lot of times when people present with these types of symptoms, they usually get sent in for an MRI or brain imaging to see if there might be anything causing that. Now with facial myokymia, there's less chance because it is usually self-resolving, but because we are kind of getting the facial nerve involved, a lot of times because those symptoms and presentations are really similar, they usually get sent in for an MRI and brain scans just to rule out any possible conditions that might be causing those symptoms. Now, hemifacial spasms, even more rare, affects 8 in 100,000 people in America right now. Now, like I said, facial myokymia can be self-resolving. Hemifacial spasms are usually not self-resolving. Usually it's chronic. A lot of times it gets worse. So if you are having these symptoms, or if we have a patient that has these symptoms with twitching eyelid, maybe it's a twitching cheek and mouth just on one side of the face, that's where the alarm bells go off, the red flags get sent up, and that's where we want to try and investigate to see if there's anything else going on. So in review, when does an eyelid twitch become worrisome? 99% of the time, we're dealing with a myokymia. So this is on one side of the face, one eye, one eyelid, and happening on one muscle group. If that's the case, then likely it's myokymia. Usually it will resolve on its own. You can help try and get rid of it by doing some lifestyle changes that we listed before. If it lasts more than 2 weeks, then it's a good idea to go in and get it checked just to rule out other possibilities. If it's happening on both eyes and both eyelids, actually kind of closing your eyelids down, possibility this could be a blepharospasm. Luckily, it's benign. It's not dangerous, but there are certain things that we want to look for and rule out certain causes. This can be treated with Botox multiple times, and usually those people do really well. If the twitch is happening on one side, maybe it's happening on both eyelids, moving down into the cheek and near the mouth, and it's just one side of the face, this is where the alarm bells go off. This is where we need to worry, and we need to start doing an MRI or imaging to rule out any possible dangerous causes. This could be a brain tumor. This could be something else pressing on the nerve, like an aneurysm, or it could be MS that's affecting the facial nerve. Have you dealt with an eyelid twitch like me? The longest one that I had was actually almost a month right after I got out of school. Very stressful time in my life. It was on and off, so it wasn't chronic, but that was probably the worst eyelid twitch I ever experienced. What did you do for your eyelid twitch? How did you get rid of it? Did it go away by itself? Leave it in the comments. I'm just curious. If you have any questions, let me know. Stay focused.